The town crier is warming up, and the whole town of Catonsville is ready for the 4th of July parade.
I've been on the committee for 12 years, and I think this is the best parade we've ever organized. We have 15 marching bands. We have entries from the American Visionary Arts Kinetics Race coming. These are sculptures on bicycles. We have all the favorites like Miss Peggy and the town crier, and we have approximately 100 entries.
And true to tradition, people have been setting out chairs along the Frederick Road parade route for weeks to make sure they get the best spot. And this year, the town crier will be dressed as Francis Scott Key in honor of the bicentennial of the War of 1812.
I will be proclaiming the beginning of the parade, proclaiming those events that happened July 4th, 1776, proclaiming those things that happened in June of 1812.
The weekend storms have affected the planning of the celebration. They were supposed to be making sandwiches in here right about now, but the Knights of Columbus building is without power, so they had to postpone it.
This storm has really affected us. I think the biggest thing has been communications. So many people's computers are down, and we rely on computers to communicate.
But Maureen promises, rain or shine, the parade will go off without a hitch, making it 66 years in a row.
This is a wonderful community to be to live in, especially the 4th of July, because everybody loves the 4th of July here. Even though all this has happened this week, they'll still be here for the 4th of July.
Catonsville is one big family. It was, I think, back in 1776, and it is today as well.
The parade is just one of many events in Catonsville that day. For a full schedule, you can find a link on our website, WBALTV.com. In Catonsville, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.